The FDA is now granting emergency use authorization for the first breath test to detect COVID-19.
And here to answer your questions this afternoon is Dr. Todd Ellerin, Chief of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. Dr. T, it's always great to see you. Great to see you on a Friday, by the way.
You too.
That's a familiar place that you are.
That's right.
He's here. Okay.
I'm closer to you guys.
He's two steps away from the anchor desk, so look out. We're coming, all right? So let's start with the obvious question. What do we know about the test, and importantly, how effective is it, Dr. T?
So, Eddie, this breathalyzer, COVID breathalyzer test looks really accurate. In studies of almost 2,500 patients with COVID, it was over 91% accurate at getting those who were positive, and importantly, over 99% at figuring out which patients were negative. So that's good news. A couple of things about this, though. It's important to know, if your test is positive with the breathalyzer, the FDA still wants you to get it confirmed by PCR, probably because it's a relatively newer test. And of course, if it's negative, you still want to make sure that, you know, that you may need to repeat it if the patient still sounds like they could have COVID. So there's some caveats involved. But remember, this is innovation, and that's so important. And we no longer have to use a nasal swab with this. Mm-hmm. I do not think this test is going to replace the rapid testing, however.
Got it.
So, but it does give doctors more options. How do you decide which test is best?
And Maria, very important. Remember, sometimes the best testing is the one that's available. So again, we've gotten used to rapid testing. I don't think that's, you know, going away. With that said, this looks very accurate. Sensitivity, specificity, close to PCR. So I think this will be in addition to the other tests that we have. Where the sweet spot is, it's a little unclear. Remember, this is sort of high tech. You've got a fancy machine about the size of a suitcase, yeah. And you know, pretty expensive, and there's some technical components to this. So it's not just gonna be like we're gonna be bringing this into our home.
So.